to slow it down. I muted the TV already, right?
Mm-hmm.
All right. We live, man.
We live. We live and direct. Coming correct.
The table look a bit. I mean,
just a little bit.
Just a little bit.
Oh, yeah, no, no. All right.
Hey, man, just got a UK accent out of nowhere.
I'm ready to start, man. I'm ready to start.
Let's get it rolling.
Episode 140.
Ooh. 140?
140.
Oh, fuck. Why is it 104?
Wow.
It's just, man, I don't know, man.
Holy! Anyways, man. Welcome.
Welcome,
everyone. Welcome to the listeners. Welcome to the viewers. Welcome to those that want to experience the True North Views Pod. Oh, he buck him up. Come on, man. Look at the uppercut.
So I'm saying, boom. Some
boom, boom.
You and me,
boom, boom, boom.
Ooh, and then the follow through.
That's a sick one.
That was a solid combo.
Holy, this guy's about to knock him out. Anyways, man, we got to start the show. True North Views Podcast. This is episode 140, Toronto's official unofficial podcast.
Yes, sir.
Discussing hip hop,
yep.
R&B, and the culture.
Culture.
Of course, new music reviews
new music,
being a vital aspect of the show.
Yes,
if
sir.
You don't know by now, I go by the name of Harris.
You know what it is? It's Dill Dot, aka the podcast K Dot, aka the caramel god, aka caramel papi. Pulling up from the logo. Dean Carter's only. Bang,
four,
bang.
4-3. Bang. I need like something to like.
4-3.
From downtown.
We'll get one for next week.
I need like.
Yeah, kind of. Like, you know, it's kind of.
I suppose.
Y'all know me. Skirt master here. Mr. Triple Double himself. I'll be passing the ball to this guy.
Jesus.
Stealing 70 mil from the TTC on my way to an NBA championship. Shout out to Toronto Raptors. You can call me Just Shola. And as usual, we are here giving you our views from the perspective of a few first generation Canadians.
You killed that.
It wasn't word for word. It was on the script, but I had to like play off in the middle.
Oh my God, he's baby. Getting bust up now. Oh my God,
he's hanging in there.
It's anyone's round.
How many rounds do these go?
I think five or some shit. Oh, I don't even know. I know nothing about this sport, bro. I'll tell you that much.
Hey, man.
What I do know is where you can follow us.
Yes,
you
sir.
Can follow us on Twitter, Instagram, and on YouTube. At True North Views, of course, on our Instagram. Wait, I go YouTube first. On our YouTube, full audio and visual experience. You can see this thing never being straight. What is this thing? Check the YouTube and find out.
You can see this has a new thing on it. What is this thing?
Check the YouTube and find out. Whatever I said the first time. Oh, my God, I got kick in the chest and
Yo, he's throwing the most. He's landing the most punches.
But he is though, yeah. Like no, but he came back in this round. Oh my God, he's done still. He's done.
Look, yeah, he's just playing defense.
That kick hit him still.
Oh,
it hurt him a little bit.
Oof. Oof. Oh my God. Oh my God. No, he's good though. He's still alive. Anyways, man, on our Instagram, of course, you will find sound bites from the respective episode for the week. Different topics of content. Different conversations from the respective episode, of course. Definitely go out on there and comment, like, share, put in your story, do all that good stuff. We definitely appreciate that. Anything to hike up the algorithm. And on our Twitter, of course. Oh my God, bro. The man gave him a book.
He's done that like twice already in the last like 30 seconds.
Fam, this fight is... I need to watch this more. This shit is fire.
It is. It's like what you said. It's the stand up of
this
UFC.
Because
there's no floor game. There's no ground and pound.
I love the ground game. Like, don't get it twisted.
Shout out to our MMA listeners. We're watching.
Glory 77. Ooh, spinning backhand or back fist or what's that move called?
Holy!
I know these moves because of UFC game.
Right.
That guy is bust.
Yeah, those guys are all concussed.
These
guys are all concussed. I was saying something about
YouTube,
our
Twitter,
random tweeting, random follow retweeting,
us.
Hashtag of the
yes.
day,
talk all that
day.
Good
follow
stuff.
Us, subscribe on YouTube, do all, come on, man, all that kind of
the
stuff.
Algorithms,
but anyway, something
guys.
Along the lines of somehow I found my way to
meditating.
Meditation, you see, is very important.
Very important.
And every time I get an update on Yahoo Fantasy, it's negative. It's always from healthy to game time decision. Yeah, so I feel very bad for that. But you know what? That awareness and acceptance of it makes things okay. My guy is coming back. Shout out to Tariq. Let's go. We out here. Oh, no, that's highlights.
That's round two highlights. Ooh, when did he do that? Kind
of, okay,
Tariq. Before the uppercut, no?
Ooh, okay.
Boom. That was a solid combo. You got a lot of points for that.
He's pretty quick still.
Round three, he got fucked. I didn't think
it was that quick. Oh, man. But he came in the beginning still.
Spinning back fist. Oof.
Oh, man.
He's buzzed, though.
He's buzzed. Is there another round? Or is there like...
I have no idea.
I have no idea either.
All
right. Anyways, man. Something along the lines of starting the show. You know what I'm saying? So let's get to the pre-potpourri. Do we want to ask how we were, or do we want to just sort of cover the two topics that we have there?
Let's just cover the two topics we have.
Yeah, let's do that.
All right, before we get there, I want to say, what's the topics?
It's a rip and a country lock off.
Okay, so go ahead. I was watching the fucking on Netflix the other day.
Pretty Little Things.
Nina Simone. You ever watch that documentary?
We all said totally different. I'm like Lupin. He said something else.
Pretty Little Things.
What
is that? I've
heard.
You say what?
That's how you know, like, when man's life changes and he starts watching Pretty Little Things.
Kind of like, I've heard it.
It happens to the best of us. It does. Like, I was caught watching Desperate Housewives. Desperate Housewives is fire, though.
Desperate Housewives is fire.
That's actually fire.
And for two, I appreciate good television. And Pretty Little Things is mud.
Is it? I'm going to check it out.
It's like All American.
Is it?
Mud.
I was watching Bridgerton.
I like All American.
Low key, it's like just mud ting. Bare shit going on.
Okay, man, I'll give it a try.
Like high school, bare shit going on. You know what I'm saying?
Because I like All American. That show is fire. That show is fire. Season 3 just started.
What was I saying? But yeah, I was watching the Nina Simone documentary. She was a cool ass person. She was the first female singer, or the first singer in general to swear on radio, to have a song on the radio that was swearing. She said damn in like 19 she said like damn in like 1950 or something like that.
Damn. Wow.
Good choice. Good choice.
So you got some coins for that one.
Holy.
Holy.
Holy for that one.
Holy.
Nina Simone documentary.
Yeah,
so you suggest we should watch it?
I would suggest to watch it. I didn't really know much about Nina Simone, to be honest. Like, other than Blonde the Leaves, like
I don't know much about her
infamous song there. Mm-hmm. But other than that, I didn't really know much about her. So it was really informative.
Cool.
Yeah, what's it called? I guess if you just search Nina Simone, you'll find it.
Yeah, it's on Netflix. Mm-hmm. You'll see it.
Okay, I gotta add it.
Before we get to lock off, let's do some rips. RIPs to two people. One, Cicely Tyson, I'm not sure how to say her name.
Cicely,
there we go, 96-year-old. Her latest role that you probably know her from is she was Annalise Keating, a.k.a. Viola Davis, mom in How to Get Away with Murder. She passed away, she was 96. She'd been acting since like the 50s.
Yeah, so she's an icon.
Shout out to her. And,
There's a photo that was circulating on Twitter with her, a family portrait with her at 2 years old in 1927.
Jeez. So she lived a long life.
A full life. She's seen a lot of shit.
She's seen a lot.
1927.
Yeah.
Rest in paradise, Cicely Tyson. Second one goes off to Six Dogs. He was a rapper that blew up. He didn't really blow up. He had one song that blew up out of Atlanta. He's out of Atlanta. Fago Dreams. Well, like 2017, I think 2016, 2017. I'm not going to say how he died yet because it's still up in speculation, so I'm not going to confirm anything, but they have confirmed that he has passed away. He was 20 in his mid-20s, so, you know, RIP to them. And, you know,
RIP.
Shake it off a little.
Yeah, let's shake that one off, please.
Let's celebrate.
Oh, yeah.
Country lock off.
The whole country lock off.
Tanayaya. Do you have the good?
Tanayaya. I'm not giving that motherfucking Ford
play. Tanayaya. Like I said in 1,000 languages.
But yeah, man. Like, obviously, COVID, stay at home. You know the vibes.
It just says stay at home. It just says stay safe now.
It should.
Maybe next week.
But recently, this was on January 29th, Air Canada, WestJet, and Sunwing. Air Canada, WestJet, and Sunwing. My bad. Federal government, they've suspended trips to sun destinations. So that includes Caribbean, Mexico as well, starting on Sunday. And apparently, it'll go until
April 30th.
That's
3 months
of no travel. International travelers will only be able to land at 4 airports: Vancouver, Calgary, Toronto, or Montreal.
Yep.
So say, for example, you wanted to go to Newfoundland.
No, international.
Okay.
You can travel like within Canada.
Okay, I'm like, hold on.
Newfoundland still within. If you want to go to like Miami and come back, you can only land 4. So if you live in like Saskatchewan, you got to figure out a way to a national airport.
It's rough.
Or one of those 4 airports.
It's rough. Interesting. Out there.
That's and that's not even the end. You're about a whole 3-day quarantine. So you have to take a mandatory test in the airport now. Before it was voluntary. Now it's mandatory. And you have to spend 3 days in a federal mandated
hotel. They should have been done that. They're fried.
At your expense,
which is about $2,000.
They should have been done
that. And then after that, you have to take a test again. If you test positive, you have to stay in another federal mandated hotel for the 14 days. If you test negative, then you're allowed to go home and continue your quarantine at home.
Yeah.
So if you test positive flying into the country, you can spend up to $10,000.
Because, yo, bro, there was a minute in time where everybody was traveling. Like, I seen on everybody's Instagram, yeah. They're in Jamaica. Like, Tulum. Yo, fam, like, we're not in a fucking pandemic.
It made no sense. They're like, yo, don't travel, but the borders are open. We're not going to do shit if you travel.
They were traveling, too. So how are we going to listen to them when they're fucking out here going on vacation?
Didn't they fire one of the cabinet members or one of the ministers for traveling on vacation last month?
Get your shit together, Canada.
So just verbatim off. That says those landing must quarantine at their own expense, mm-hmm. which the Prime Minister Justin Trudeau says will cost around $2,000
for 3 days. For 3 days. 3 days.
Passengers that are already down south, they will be contacted by their airline to organize return to Canada. And a Canadian flight suspension to Mexico, will last until April 30th.
If you know anyone that's by the time this happens, when I hear this, it's too late. But according to what I heard, these people that booked the vacation are not actually contacting them. They're just sending them emails, mm-hmm. and like, oh, here's their email saying we're canceling your return trip. Here's a refund. But if you miss that email, because I know someone that works in travel industry, and she's saying if they miss that email, they're screwed. Wow. And a lot of people are going to miss that email. Some people did catch it. You should be checking your email.
Yeah, I was going to say, in a lot of ways, you should be checking your email.
I check it daily, even if I don't expect nothing. But
yeah,
it's just one of those things that there are going to be some people on vacation that are going to be on Tuesday, like, oh, I'm ready to go home. And they'll be like, yo, your flight got psych.
That was in my junk mail for 11 days before I saw it.
Junk mail? Because of work?
I was like...
That shit pisses me off.
Because of work?
I'm a still from the logo. And it went in, man.
Jeez!
That's all it was saying.
Because of work, I realized to check my junk mail. Like, there's some program we work with, but when we send it to people, it always goes to their junk mail. So because of that, I always check my junk mail now.
Mm.
Yeah, never find anything there most of the time. Like once a year, I might find something. But
you got to check.
It happens.
You definitely have to check. Are we going music potpourri?
Let's go.
Musica, let's go.
Let's do it.
Musica de Harry Fry. Musica de potpourri.
La musica de potpourri.
HBDs. Oh, you want to introduce music popular?
Yo, this is the guy from... Oh, I knew that guy. That's the guy. Did you ever watch...
Ultimate Fighter?
Nah. What's the Netflix reality show called? Where they're in the room, they never see each other.
Oh!
Love is Blind?
No. I know what you're talking about. Like, The Circle.
Room Rate, The Circle. He's from The Circle France.
I didn't watch the French one.
Wow.
I gotta watch it. Yo. Now I gotta watch it.
Do you see how many... What? You see this guy's record? That's him? What?
It's like 143 to like bro. 13.
And like 50 knockouts, bro.
Nah, Cedric is on there, yo.
Cedric Dumbe or Cedric Grandhart?
What's it called?
This guy's an animal.
I watched Circle France, yo.
Who even has 142 fights?
Why you look that up?
That's crazy.
So starting music potpourri, happy birthdays.
Happy birthday.
Do we have a thing?
I thought we did.
Happy birthday.
No, we just do the celebrate.
Happy birthday.
Shout out to Dylan for the voice.
Got you.
Kid Cudi turned 37 sometime this week.
Oh, yeah. Let's go around the applause. It wasn't supposed to be that long.
That's a long applause, though.
Dylan's favorite rapper, J. Cole, turned 38.
Okay.
Wow, he's old, too. Shit.
Wow, these guys are old. Look.
That's him? No, it's not.
That is him. What do you mean? Look up the characters.
And the big boss himself, Ricky Rosé, turned 45.
Kind of close. Shout out to you guys. Hey, happy birthday. Hey.
Yeah, it's a lot of hip-hop birthdays.
Honestly, it just felt like that. I didn't realize until after I did it. But
a lot of hip-hop birthdays.
Happy birthday to all these people.
I'm going to warn you guys on this music potpourri. It seems to be all about Drake.
Another Drake cast.
Drake.
So who wants to Drake's their season. First Drake topic?
I'll do it because I added two of these Drake topics. Yeah, when I hear just no notes, I'm like, oh, don't worry, I got you, Drake. That's it. We got Drake. Oh, it is Cedric. It says right there, Cedric Toulé.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
But that's probably why they got him, because he was a name.
And that's what he said. I mean, he kickboxes.
Oh, shit. Oh, so it is him.
I thought he was just like, you know.
Yeah,
I bought. This guy is on Glory 77 in a main event at 100 wins.
Shout out to him.
That's crazy.
Drake wants to see an Usher versus Timberlake. Oh, sorry. An Usher versus Justin Timberlake versus. He told this to, I forgot who. Oh, Timberland. And yeah, that's much it. What do you guys feel about Justin Timberlake versus Usher versus?
I feel like it breaks the rules.
What's the
rules?
Why?
I don't know what's the rules. So?
There's rules and verses?
Well, I feel like there's inherent rules.
Okay.
Well, what are these? I don't know watch versus. So I'm asking because I don't know what these inherent rules are.
I just think the audience in whom we're like, don't get me wrong, gotcha. Like JT.
I got you. JT's a guy.
JT got the black audience.
But listen, but he's not black.
He's not black.
So,
but I see what you're saying. the way Dylan said it,
not black.
That's what he was trying to say in a PC version.
And then there's also the stigma or the conception of JT of being a vulture in the culture.
Mm-hmm. Right about that.
So I don't think so. But anyways, let's take that to the side for now.
Okay.
Yeah. Let's take the actual.
Usher person. Is smoking JT's boots.
I don't think you can say smoking on either
smoking.
Side.
Smoking his boots.
I do think Usher wins.
I think Usher wins, but I don't think.
What? What's JT gonna play when Nice and Slow comes on?
I said one song.
Nice and
the
Slow.
The man has bare music. My way. He has a whole band.
He has that. And I was gonna say, is NSYNC allowed?
But they've been.
It's allowed.
Oh, if NSYNC's allowed, okay, he's not smoking.
Usher's career is a long career, right? So like, he has to.
If you were in a duo, if you were in a group, if you were solo, it's your music. You're allowed to play your.
Fair
if
enough.
You wrote
I don't
for
know.
It. Your music.
Okay, fair enough. In that case, because that's one of my questions: is JT allowed to use
JT's? And he's got bangers like Don't Sleep. JT's got bangers, but not culturally relevant bangers like Usher.
He has that song with T.I.
I think he does. I think he does. That's another side. Not culturally relevant.
To the right,
but. And I think he has a lot of records that would kind of respark people's memory in a way that would actually give it extra points.
A million percent.
But
so when it comes to the cultural impact, because it is versus. Yeah. When it comes to the cultural impact, he's losing on that end.
Yes.
But what does cultural impact mean?
Black people fuck with it.
Black people fuck with it.
What does that have to do with the score?
It's just people. You see all the time in the verses like, oh shit, that's a banger.
But people said about everything.
That's what I'm saying.
Oh,
about
y'all didn't
but it's
know.
Usher though against JT.
Everyone didn't know.
And then
this is 20 biggest hits ever.
No, it's fact.
It's all number three on the billboards.
You know what I'm saying though?
But like, everyone didn't know. Holy.
I get what you're saying, but I get what you're saying though, because like if I'm at a club and Justin Timberlake and Usher was coming,
I'm
Usher
jamming.
Will bomb more than JT.
I don't know about that.
I'm not saying JT will bomb.
I might not agree with that one still.
You think JT will bomb
in the
more
club,
than Usher?
JT's got some bangers in the club.
Oh, I do think so, but like, you know, if we do 20 to 20, I think Usher will. People will bump more to Usher songs than they bump more to JT songs.
It's a lot closer than I think that I'm thinking.
Yeah.
Now that I'm thinking
closer,
about it.
Yeah, it's not a smoke.
But I'm still
but
thinking.
But I do think it's like a 12-8 type of scenario.
It's one of those close. It depends on which order. It
could be even 11-9.
I think we have to use the same metric with Keyshia Cole and Ashanti. Like when it comes to like the haymaker rounds, who's taking those?
And I think JT has like a few 4 or 5 songs that can just like, it's a trump card. That's like,
and so
whatever
Usher.
You play.
That's what I'm saying. But you got to play the haymaker.
Usher has like a 4 or 5 trump
haymakers.
Cards.
Oh, yeah.
And then see how they stack
every
up.
Every single round in every single verse.
Yo, Yaza song.
Every single
round. Ludacris played it, Lil Jon played it.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Whoever produced it played it.
Verses. That's insane.
Everyone that was on that song played it.
They had to. It was an auto point.
Drake snippets.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. There's some Drake snippets that are out.
Who put this? You did?
I think I did.
I didn't listen to it yet. So
you didn't want
to
hear it?
I took a little listen.
I don't really listen to snippets.
Yeah,
I don't like it.
If I come across it, I'll listen to it, but I wouldn't look for it.
I thought I would for the podcast.
Yeah, do it for the podcast. I listen to what leak did I listen to? Oh, I listen to Drake leak for the podcast. He's still on my phone.
Link with V if I'm down in Baton. Link with Taz. Link with C when I'm down in Jackson. Just got back overseas, I was the main attraction. This ain't them, this is me, so you know what's cracking.
I mean, it's not even a doubt. You know what I'm about. Before I made it out, I said I've got to make it out. And I did. I did. Yeah. I really did.
Hard as fuck.
I'm good.
The really?
No.
I was saying, who wrote this paper, Cardi? Like, yo, it's so weak. Like, that's a weak Drake verse.
All three of them are weak.
That was a weak Drake verse.
I wasn't blown away at all.
Exactly.
Let me play the third. I wasn't impressed with the first one at all, so I skipped over that one. Let me play the third one here, if I may.
Yeah. I'm in New York and you're on Long Island. I don't even treat you that good, girl. Why you smiling? It's 3 a.m. Why you driving? Why you stopping for gas to get on the highway? Just to end up.
So I don't even treat you that good. Why are you smiling?
Dude, Drake's a savage.
That's rude.
Super.
This guy's been jogging at the entrance for how long? That was my favorite character in the circle.
Cedric Doom. Did he win? I don't know.
No, he didn't win still. Okay. I was cheesed when he got kicked off. I'm like, yo, they liked him though. Wow. But they liked him.
Hey. Was he playing himself or was he someone else?
He was playing himself.
Oh, okay.
He was playing himself. The circle fronts.
I wasn't feeling any of those Drake's features.
I
Hope Those Don't Make the Album.
I wasn't blown away. Speaking of Drake.
That's just maybe our last Drake topic for today. According to Charlamagne, he says...
Is this the... Do you have the audio?
Yes, I have the audio. I'll play it right now. Let me just mute this.
Drake is still Drake. Sorry, guys.
Panicking. He's panicking.
I am panicking. Because it doesn't... Like, I just want to refresh it.
They should have a refresh.
Like, there's a little circle at the top.
There was a time when a Drake feature helped a little baby. Yeah. I think right now Drake might need that little baby feature.
Drake is still Drake.
Let's be clear, a lot of the Drake records, at least of late, haven't really, you know, taken off at radio.
What's the record he released?
Laugh Now Cry Later.
We played it every other song.
Yes, it was the number one.
Yeah, it was
Now I will start by saying Charlamagne did say in the comments I was hating a little.
Yeah.
Because Drake, like the guy said, like the producer said, we play Drake every other song. Yeah. But all this was just to say, do you think a Lil Baby feature right now is worth more than a Drake feature?
Absolutely not.
Okay, I don't think so either.
That's insane.
But your little brother, would he think that?
No, he won't.
Okay, I don't
know. Like, I don't even know who I'm going for. That's the thing, though. Like,
why does guy bet against his boy?
Nah, Doumbé looks like a beast, though.
Okay, I bet on my guy Cedric Doumbé.
5'10".
Nah, watch this. He's going to crush him. There's all these guys from the Netherlands, man.
Must be the sport there.
That's a little scary.
Win percentage, 91. That's crazy.
Oh, that's crazy. Almost 60. Well, this guy's at 58 too, so KO percentage.
Bro, combined damn near 200 fights.
That's wild.
This guy's a brain.
What are we talking about?
That was all the question.
Man, Charlamagne just be saying shit sometimes.
He
did, like,
honestly, he
say
was.
Some shit?
Just to say some shit.
Because he did say he was hating, but that was just to see the little
bit. Is there any truth in that statement?
I think it depends on who you ask.
Well, he needs a Wayne feature?
No, not that he needs a feature.
Is a Lil Baby feature worth more than a Drake feature?
Right now.
Definitely not.
If Drake feature, as an index value, right? If Drake feature was a mil, how much is Lil Baby?
That's a good way to put it.
Like 500?
500.
I'm putting like 850.
850?
Like if Drake is a mil. Like
if Drake is a mil, Lil Baby is 850? Okay,
right now. No, not 850.
How much is Travis Scott?
Okay, no, Travis
Scott. Travis right now?
Drake is a mil.
It's less than Baby.
The index, Drake is a mil.
Less than Baby for sure.
Well, Travis Scott?
How much is Travis Scott?
I'm actually putting Travis Scott higher than Drake when it comes to using him. Because of what he brings. Like... I don't know how to explain this, but like...
A feature from Travis Scott is worth more than Drake?
A feature from Travis Scott brings people in that don't just listen to music. That's why Fortnite niggas gonna listen to you because of Travis Scott. Fortnite niggas not listen to you because of Drake.
Drake doesn't do the same thing.
My grandma's listening to Drake.
Drake doesn't do the exact same thing in five different countries.
I think that's crazy. In the UK, in Jamaica, in Canada, in the States. Travis Scott.
In Germany.
I think Travis Scott's worth... is because of what he brings is worth more. Like the audience he brings is worth more than what Drake brings. In that's all I'm saying. But I'm not saying like it's a bit, you're gonna get a better song. I think but it's worth more than a Drake feature. I'll say yes.
I have to strongly
disagree. So if Drake disagree. Is a mil on the index and Lil Baby's 500, like this is like power levels. At okay, this
Travis
point.
Scott's 1.2. Like... I'm putting that here. look at how much endorsement this guy had. You think he's gonna be cheap for a feature?
Hey, man. That's a crazy statement.
But... Look at his endorsement. You really think his features are going to be cheap? When they're like, yo, why would I do your feature when I can just go do this endorsement? And now wow. I'm doing this endorsement. So now people are going to look up Travis Scott, see that I featured you on my song.
So I think Drake is the most valuable feature in the game right now.
No, Drake is the most valuable if you want to bring it to you. Like, if I'm doing a song, I'd rather put Drake than Travis Scott. But I think Travis Scott costs more. Like, his team just makes their...
First of all, Drake costs the most by far, but...
I don't think so. That's what I'm saying.
Okay, even forget who costs, because that's speculating. I'm saying, who's just more... Even though it's speculative as well. Who's this?
I think Drake's is worth more...
Drake is the index $1 million worth of value. Yeah. Not cost. Worth of value.
Worth of value? I still think Travis
Scott. How much is Travis Scott is value? How much is his value? 1.2 if Drake is a mil?
No, I was talking about cost in that case.
That's wild.
I don't know, but I think Travis Scott...
At this very moment in time, Baby is more valuable than a Travis Scott feature.
And let's not forget, Drake sold what, $750? So. Travis Scott sold, $720?
A 1,000,000%. But that's just by me...
Okay, let me ask you a question.
Like, on Heat.
Actually, never mind.
On Heat.
I answered my own question.
Wait, let me ask you a question. I'm sure I answered it.
On the Heat scale.
I was going to say...
Baby's just a little bit more on fire right now than Travis Scott is.
So which record would be more fire, but then answer. I was gonna say, Cordae featuring Travis Scott, or Cordae featuring Lil Baby,
which would be more fire.
Which would be more? That's fire.
Travis Scott.
See that's
but
my
the thing
point.
Is, Travis Scott misses. Mm. He misses sometimes. He Baby
but
hasn't
only
missed
on, like Jackboy shit.
Baby hasn't missed in a while, in over a year. He hasn't missed.
These guys are swinging like it's a video game.
So true. I think on a Travis Scott Cordae track, that'd be a miss. I don't think that it would blend well, but it sounds crazy, but I don't think it would blend well.
No, Travis Scott's done stuff with production that surprises me.
That's true, and Cordae is talented.
Like that bursting in the trap.
I think Travis Scott is worth more still. Mm-hmm. I think if Drake is a mil, a Lil Baby's like 200, and Travis Scott is like 600.
Mm. Fair enough.
And like Benny is like 180.
Okay. Yeah.
190.
Okay.
Because like, a Drake feature is still extremely valuable.
It is. And I'm not saying it's not like, valuable. Like, I just think Travis Scott's worth a little bit more. That's just what I think. But
yeah,
what do
Travis
I know?
It's like 600. Are we moving on to... No, we're not. Fun fact time. This is about music. We know that it's hard to keep up with music that has come out. There's some statistics to prove it. And these statistics are provided by It's The Real.
Shout out to It's The Real.
So first of all, Wale says, has there ever been a time in music where this many songs sound the same? And then It's The Real commented and said, there's never been a time in music with this many songs, period. In 2018, which we still thought was an abundance of music, there were 24,000 songs were uploaded to streaming services a day.
Wow.
Right? 24,000.
A day. I know I read that as a year.
A day. A day.
Jeez,
right?
Louise.
By 2019, it was 40,000.
A day.
A day. Right?
The fuck?
In 2020, it was 86,000.
That is nutty. I need like, fuck.
Now, I will say some of what is being uploaded is like people's old shit under a different name.
Absolutely.
Like, I found mixtapes. I'm like, yo, who the fuck is this? Not Lil Wayne mixtape. It's not by Lil Wayne, but it's a Lil Wayne mixtape. No, that is still a wild number.
That's insane.
That's a wild number still.
That's actually dumb. That actually makes no sense whatsoever.
Yeah. It doesn't surprise me.
What did Wale say?
He says something about, has there ever been an era in music where this many songs sound the same?
Oh.
No, but it's also like an old head thing he's kind of saying. And people are going to take that as an old head.
In some degree.
In some degree, yes.
I do agree with that.
I do agree and I don't agree in a way.
Yeah.
I do agree that in a lot of times, like 20 years from now, we're going to forget about the shitty songs. Mm-hmm. The same way we forgot about the shitty songs from the 90s.
Fact. I'm pretty sure
in
the 90s, they all sounded the same.
All sounded the same, but then the goods last and the shitty guys. Like, look at the rockers from 20, all the lils from 2015. The ones that were good stuck around till now. So, that's true. Music is a lot easier to make or... Yeah, it's a lot easier to make now. Like, people can make music in their bedroom.
Exactly. And that's a lot more accessible.
A lot more accessible.
There. Just the perspective of having, like, 40,000 songs a day coming out, some shit's going to sound the same.
Oh, yeah, and that's why, I mean, like, he does have a point in that.
That makes sense.
And because music is easy to make, people make the easiest kind of music, right, which is probably the one that sounds most the same.
That's fine.
Facts.
He's a champion. And the other one's 1C.
Oh, he hit him, though.
I had to put 1C and not number 2. He's number 1
contender?
Oh, there we go. I'm like number 1 champion. Next in line. Next time a walk contender makes more sense now.
But these guys are just flailing. Like, I think I would be Cedric in a boxing match.
Yeah, but he's not a boxer.
I know. That's my point.
That's why he does this. He can fail.
No, he would not.
In boxing, you can't fail like this.
He would beat me still. He would beat me still. Look at that. Come on, man.
Look
at that. Look at that.
Was he the one that punched? Who's Cedric?
The guy that knocked him out.
Ooh.
Damn.
Oh, he's hurt.
Yeah, he fell. That one.
And that fall wasn't an off-balance fall. That was like a knocked out fall.
Look, he can't even
I'm
walk.
Sleepy.
I was like, yo, where's my bed?
Holy, that's crazy.
What do we got next? Oh,
keep it or leak it.
Oh, shit, I was there on the music. Big Lotto has said she won't be releasing any music until her name change has been revealed. No, she must have listened to me.
Listen, we've been reporting on this for quite some time.
And that's why
so I am going to give us credit
for
Big Lotto.
Big Lotto listens to the podcast. Hey, shout out to Big Lotto.
Friend of the show.
Big Moo Moo.
Friend of the show. Friend of the show.
Little baddie.
She's not announced what her name is going to be yet. She says on Twitter people have guessed it right. But she says she's not going to announce it publicly yet. It's probably going to be Big Lotto, to be honest.
Yeah.
I think so
she
too.
Said the reason why her name changed is because of the negative connotations. Like, it wasn't... She didn't pick the name, one.
Yeah.
And two, she didn't mean it to be bad. She was just kind of like trying to accept what she is. Oh, wait, what the hell? How's he outside?
Did he headbutt himself?
Yo, fuck up him back!
The man's on the judge's table!
Yo, the man broke up him back!
You don't want to be signed for the
man! You tried to give him a tiger knee from the top.
Fam.
If he can't continue, that's a TKO.
Fam, man, broke up him back!
Damn. Yo, he busts up himself, yo.
I've never seen that before. I've never seen anything like that in my life before. That's crazy.
That's crazy.
Yo,
that was way more than 10 seconds.
My guy flew out the ring, bro.
He tried to do a tiger knee. And he just dodged it on some Goku shit.
Yo, the man hurt.
Yo, the only man broke up his back.
I want to see this.
The man landed on his back.
Yo, UFC would have been showed a fucking replay by now.
Anyway,
Big
Lotto.
Do you think her name changes to something other than Big Lotto? I guess is my question.
No, my guess is Big Lotto. I have no.
What are they saying on the Twitter sphere?
I have no idea. I wasn't gonna look into it.
Oh,
the man fell on a WWE table.
The man thought he had it too. Now like one pick, I got him with a kick.
At the corner of the ring on. Ooh, I feel that. Oops.
Yo, at least hit it too. If you're gonna do, at least hit.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Man got power bombed. Fuck, that's some shit. All right, man. New music time.
Shout out to Big Lotto.
Shout out to Big Lotto.
We used our master list this time. Did you guys see it? I didn't send it to you.
Yeah, I saw it.
Yeah,
you sent it.
I did send it.
I'm pulling it up right now.
Okay, good. I did send it. Okay. In our old school vintage fashion, then
it's finally back.
We're gonna go with albums and singles. Let's start announcing those. So Madlib came out with an album. Of course, we're gonna go through first. That album is called Sound Ancestors. Lil Durk came out with a deluxe version of. Oh, he put him to sleep. Who said that? Oh. It's crazy, bro.
I'm
gonna rewatch Circle Friends just for that. Up until he gets eliminated, and then I'm gonna stop watching. Lil Durk came out with a deluxe version of The Voice. Rich the Kid came out with Lucky 7. Deontay Hitchcock with Live from Quarantine.
Pee Wee Longway and Cassius J came out with Longway Sinatra 2.
Oh, yeah, my phone. And then Mickey Fax came out with Hugh and Audio Last Will and Testament.
That's
all I got.
Honestly, that's all I got too.
And then singles, which I listened to none this week.
Brent Faiyaz featuring DJ Dahi. Gravity featuring Tyler the Creator. Freddie Gibbs came out with Daddy Loves You. And Alfredo Vinyl bonus tracks. So if you're into the vinyl, you got that. Kodak Black. came out with Last Day In.
Boom.
Knowledge came out with Net Pop and Poor Shots. Max B featuring Giggs.
His eyes were in the air. Watch this. Boom.
Be out. Max B featuring Giggs. Bad to the Bone. JPEG Mafia. Fix Yourself. Nick Caution. Kochek. Session 54. The Alchemist. Carry the Fire. Lil Mosey. Holy Water. Ty Dolla Sign, Spicy, featuring J Balvin, YG, Tyga, and Post Malone. Damn, this guy got all the hitmakers on.
Yeah,
that. Holy shit. Oh, it says, Drakeo the Ruler. Honestly, that's all I have.
Okay.
Everyone else here, I don't really know.
Shit, okay. In terms of what was listened to, I obviously listened to the most content here.
You did.
But hey, you know, it is what it is. What can I say? What can I say? No, I'm joking. But okay, I'll quickly touch on Deontay Hitchcock Live from Quarantine.
Live.
That is simply a live version of the Better album.
Okay.
Which is interesting because I think Better has something like 10 records on there.
Off his Better. No, his album was Better.
Yeah.
I think like the Better off his albums. I was like, that's so weird. But now I get it now. The Better is the name of the album.
Yes.
Is that a double entendre?
No.
Don't even ask me how.
Shit, I'll give you that still.
Don't even ask me how.
I'll give you that. But yeah, no, it's a record. I mean, a live version of that. Like I said, it's interesting because the regular version of it has 10 songs on it. The deluxe version has 20 songs on it, but the live version has 14.
So he took 6 songs out of the deluxe version?
I couldn't tell you. I don't know. I didn't check. I don't do all that work at that point. It's in different order. I'm like, listen.
Yeah, that's what once you put in a different order.
How much cross-referencing do I got to do?
Back and forth.
God damn it. I'm not mad at it. I mean, you know, just overworking, for lack of a better word, the album. I mean, doing a deluxe, doing a live, why not?
There's no money on it. You can't tour.
Exactly. So, you can't really tour.
I don't blame them for
doing
stuff like
this. I don't want to give out new content, but I still want to stay on your mind.
Mm-hmm.
And this, of course, a live version of that, right? What I was going to ask in general was just, how do you guys feel about live albums or those Spotify sessions? Or
I think those are fire.
I like them. Or whatever.
Like, me as a person that grew up playing instruments, I love when when a person can come out that normally doesn't usually have live instrumentation with their music, and they do a live rendition of that. It's fire. Like, when I went to watch The Weeknd a couple years ago, his band was crazy. Like, it just adds a different level.
Mm-hmm. Anderson Paak.
Anderson Paak has a good one. Anderson Mac Paak Miller with Thundercat. For his that. Tiny Desk performance was crazy.
And Tiny Desk, that was my next Tiny Desk. Yeah. I love those Tiny Desk.
I love that shit.
And I feel like that, I like live because it shows your true talent. Mm-hmm. You can hide behind auto-tune. You can hide behind all the producers. Yeah. But live audio?
Or maybe raw talent?
Raw talent is what I'll call it. Yeah, it just shows your raw talent. Like, you don't have to be the best singer, but you know, show me the raw talent.
It just makes it feel live. Like, you get a different feeling from the music.
Yeah, it's like you're in the room. You're speaking to me directly, not through a bunch of processors.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know where this was live streamed, but again, you have to just salute him for the creativity of capturing it, because there's times where it almost sounds like he's talking to, say, a YouTube audience, for example. Mm-hmm. Hey, you guys liking this shit?
So it's like almost like a live show.
Well,
it is
a live show. And you get that feeling where, like, I'm like, wait, hold up, he didn't snip this part out? Like, that's what I was thinking to myself. So, but at the same time, it gave it that feel, like, I'm like, oh, okay, this actually is a performance and not just, say, a live version of the song, if that makes sense.
Oh, okay, so, I see what you're saying.
Yeah.
Do you hear crowds in the background, like yelling?
No, I didn't. Okay. I don't think so. I don't specifically recall, but I don't think so. No, but interesting. It is interesting. Again, it's a different order. The songs kind of blend into one another. It's that live version of it. It feels concerty in some ways. So definitely, you know, worth a listen if you like that album. If you haven't listened to Deontay Hitchcock before, maybe listen to the album first before listening to the live version.
Yes.
But yeah, I mean, it's a good alternative to the album, and I'm not mad at that. I'm not mad at that at all. I'll talk about
Mickey Fax.
Yeah. And then I'll talk about Mickey Fax. Yeah.
Okay, then I can talk about Rich the Kid quickly.
All right. So for Mickey Fax, Mickey Fax came out with Hue in Audio, Last Will and Testament. This is 10 songs at 30 minutes. Hold on, I gotta load it up here.
That's cool. 10 songs, 30 minutes. Mickey Fax, Hue and Audio, Last Will and Testament. Is this his first drop this year? Did he drop anything last year?
I don't know.
I feel like you would have talked about it a lot more because you like Mickey Facts, no?
I do like Mickey
Facts. Because I remember when you dropped 2018, you loved that album. It was almost on your...
No, you're thinking about Mick Jenkins.
Oh, yeah. But... Mick Jenkins. Yes, you're right.
No, I do like Mickey Facts. I don't maybe actively listen to his music. He did come out with a project in 2020 called Warped Collages. And this one, again, is called Hue and Audio Last Will and Testament. Okay, now that I have it in front of me, I can finally talk about it. So, I mean, again, for this album, it's hard to even dissect it from the beginning because you kind of have to know who Mickey Facts is. Mm-hmm. Or at the very least, you have to kind of know what crowd he's in.
Is he in the TDE crowd? Kind of. He's affiliated with TDE? I think so. I'm not sure. I'm asking.
I feel like I heard about Mickey Facts in like when I was like grade 10.
I'm trying to. Yeah, he's been around.
He's been around for a minute. I feel like I've heard about him most with TDE.
He's real good friends with Lupe.
Okay.
Maybe not TD. I don't think I saw someone else with TD. Maybe I'm thinking of Mick Jenkins with TD.
And I have no clue. No clue at all whatsoever. But yeah, no, Mickey Facts, like I said, I mean, the album won't blow you away. His style won't blow you away, right? It's not for everyone. I don't think it's meant to be for everyone. In some ways, it's kind of for hip-hop heads. I think I was reading a review on it, and it said it's steady. It's steady, it's bars without the flash, it's lyricism. I'm not going to say he's super lyrical miracle, but you kind of put him adjacent to that kind of alien category the same way you would a Lupe.
He's a wordsmith.
As we said last week, Pharoah Monch, the same way you would kind of put them in that category, you would to some degree do the same thing with Mickey Facts. I feel like he's the same type of artist in that regard, right? This album... Based on the artwork, I mean, it seems to have something to do with his son. So I don't know if that's a new birth or I don't know how old that kid is. But I don't know how many kids he has either. But there's definitely some element of like parenthood on this album. So I wonder if that, you know, speaks to people that have kids because I ain't got no kids. But let me play a little bit of track 3. That one's
called Any Features on this album?
Yeah, every record.
Oh,
yeah, every record. Right, Tony Williams, Joe Andre, we have Novel, Renz Young. Bun B, Sharif Keys, Bay God, Nicholas Gant, and Showtime. Gant.
Showtime.
I'm gonna play a little bit of track 3 that has no features. That one's called You Can Do It. You can take two people came together and made one. That's a double entendre that I create, son. Look where your face from. A little bit of me and a brother remain young. Mommy, where you getting your shade from? You can take it two ways like old phones. Quiet as ever, that's also sort of like my brothers when I wore. Yeah, you know, that type of rap. Again, it's not going to blow you away. It's not fun hip-hop, for lack of a better word, but it's kind of just steady. It's a solid listen. It's a decent listen. It's from New York. You get that New York feel on it. Soul samples, boom bap, that type of stuff. Lo-fi-esque at times. I enjoyed it. Mickey Facts, Hue. And Audio Last Will and Testament, definitely listen to that.
Let me tell you about an album I did not enjoy.
Speaking of.
My favorite.
Lucky 7 by Rich the Kid. This featured 1, 2, 3.
Well, you had high expectations for 4, Rich the Kid?
4, 5, 6, 7. No. It was still a shitty album.
Yo, Rich the Kid is a solid feature rapper. Yo.
He's a good feature rapper.
As I talk about this, that was one of my issues with this. Just I got tired of him after three songs.
I don't want a whole project from you.
Saying anything I need to listen to more than a verse of you. So this song features, actually it's 7 tracks and features about 8 people. He should have kept it at 7. It has a single which features Ruby Rose, Flo Milli, and Mulatto.
I hate that record.
Sidebar. Who the fuck is Ruby Rose?
Some next rapper. Some rapper. Female rapper.
Is she nice? Because I see her name around a lot.
Like, she's nice with the bars. I'll say it that way.
I don't know. I don't actively listen to
her. I've only listened to her like once, and that was at her friend's house. She played on TV, so we had no choice. I had no idea. When she said Ruby, I thought she was going to play the actress. I was like, oh, the actress started singing?
Oh, come on.
And I saw a black lady singing. I was like, oh.
I'm so confused.
Yeah. I've heard of her once.
Let's play a random record from
Ruby. Popular song on
Rose. Most popular record is called, most latest release is called For the Streets. This came out on Christmas Day.
She's for the streets. I was like, now we know where she's for.
The album artwork, that's insane. It's not loading.
Okay. Well,
no, it is loading. It is loading. No. Sorry, that was a project. Oh, so let me play project. A little bit of that. He and his feelings. He keep coming back. He on repeat. Yeah, pussy, play him again. Why did he want some to do it again? He coming right over again. He gotta come fuck me again. He back in his feelings. He calling me just to come tell me he's.
Like, she has a bump. Yeah. I won't lie to her. Every time I've heard her, she has a bump. But
that's a little vibe still.
It's just one of those things. Same reason I don't listen to Meg Thee Stallion. You know, we're on different topics. So this features DaBaby, Sip T, Lil Mosey, Flo Milli, Mulatto, Ruby Rose, Quavo, and Takeoff, which I thought was the best song, but we don't play because I don't want to give these guys no listens.
Wow.
Not even like that. Just one of those, like, honestly.
We need a gunshot.
It's not. Again, it's Rich the Kid, like you said. He's a feature artist.
That's the gunshots?
Yeah,
right. What kind of gun is that?
It's PG. A Doom. Doom 97.
It's PG, okay? We're not trying to actually have pop pop on
it. It's from Doom 97.
That's crazy. Yo, Doom is crazy. But sorry, man.
So, yeah, the first song, Rich the Kid Split, was only Rich the Kid. And, you know, okay, cool. Second song.
That's what kind of gun was that?
A lot of Rich the Kid again. Featured DaBaby. And that song was fire because DaBaby did have a bumpy verse on it. Mm-hmm. Sip T, I kind of skipped. Lil Mosey, I didn't feel that song. I'm not going through track by track. All in all, same thing you said. It's just, it's Rich the Kid. You can't listen to a whole project about Rich the Kid.
There's no standout tracks
The last track, Too Blessed, featuring Quavo and Takeoff. And I think honestly, it was good to hear Quavo and Takeoff on the track again.
Mm. Yeah.
As much as we did hear a lot of them. It's just one of those that you, it was a voice I was familiar with and they flowed well. I'm like, oh shit, Takeoff's pretty nice. I forgot.
One of these pages had like a little like, no, they just be asking, hey, is so-and-so the baddest in the game? Like, you know, just be asking.
It's random, she just gets followed together.
So it was something along the lines of Migos, Originators of the Sound type thing, and they were playing their old shit. I was like, yo, these guys were like, yo, like, they had that hunger, like, yes, when they weren't on top.
When they weren't on top, yeah. Versace, yeah. That's a fire song. You Versace got on it.
Versace.
Medusa head on me like I'm Illuminati.
Oh, you said Too Blessed featuring Too Quavo Blessed. And Takeoff?
Yes.
Yeah, this record, I'm Too Blessed. This song is like 50 years old.
I never heard this song before. I'm sorry.
No, come on, man.
I swear I never heard this
song. You're lying, bro.
I swear I never heard this song.
Come on, man.
I swear I never heard this song.
This is on every playlist. Too Blessed?
I make my own playlist. I listen to those. But either way, that's my favorite song off the album. So.
Oh, yeah. Too Blessed is a big record.
But again, Rich the Kid sounds like Rich the Kid on every track. But if you like Rich the Kid, you'll like this album. Let me put it that way.
Okay.
I like Rich the Kid's first album that had features on every track.
That's when he had the Kendrick feature, no?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah.
He was
like that. New Freezer or something like that?
New Freezer. Freezer.
I like that song.
But, yeah.
New Freezer's a record. That's a club classic.
Alchemist or?
I'm going to go with
Mickey Facts.
Just continuing kind of on the Mickey Facts commentary as I lead into Madlib. Right? So Madlib, Sound Ancestors. This is 16 songs, 41 minutes. I mentioned this to you guys as we were listening to about 15 minutes of it. That is what we were listening to. I'll kind of give the same baseline opinion about Mickey Facts. It's not for everyone.
Mm-hmm.
It's definitely not for everyone. You know, it's straight instrumentals on this. So, you know, some people don't prefer that.
There's some vocals sprinkled in there.
Is there?
Yeah, I thought I heard a little something.
No.
On a couple tracks.
No.
Maybe I was tripping. Anything. Maybe it was a different project.
Yeah, I think you were tripping still. this album is going to give you a lot
if I just started.
Of snare.
It's a highlight.
Drums. And I'll show you those snare drums on track 3 as I try to load up the album. Track 3 is called Theme the Crabtree. Theme the Crabtree. Sorry about that. That's just kind of it. And then track 4 is called Road of the Lonely Ones. In some ways, again, we just speak into that instrumentation factor. That's definitely a factor in this. You know, even to a point where sometimes it sounds like you're at like a live jazz show. With the title track, which is called Sound Ancestors. I'll play a little bit of that one.
I feel like we should be doing some spoken word over this right now.
You know what's funny? Hello. I'll bring it up in my what's my rotation is that instrumentals were a lot of my this week. Because I just think I'm like, yo, how are you in a studio? Someone sends you this and like, yo, create a rap song. I'm like, they make it though. But like, like, exactly. Like, I was thinking about that. Trust me. When my instrumentals, I was listening to that. I was pulling off on freestyles. It wasn't good, but you know, in my head, I had a crowd.
No, I was nice though. I wasn't that nice though. But I was not. Like I was saying, the straight instrumental won't be for everyone. I think that's okay. It might not even be for hip hop heads. It kind of gives you more of that live play element to it, rather than just beats, so to speak. So, you know, kind of listener beware from that perspective. But I liked it. I think there's a lot of layers to it. I think I can see myself listening to this sort of throughout the remainder of the year and just kind of uncovering new layers as I listen to it. So I'm looking forward to kind of making this one kind of cook over time.
Okay.
In the first 1.5 to 2 times that I've listened to it, I like it. Right. I like it. Madlib Sound Ancestors, I think worth a download and worth a listen for sure. And I'll quickly talk Alchemist because that one's called Carry the Fire.
Is it another instrumental?
It's 8 songs before I answer that question. Okay. It's 8 songs. 8 songs.
Oh, songs. Oh, there you
go. And 9 minutes.
Oh, shit.
For real?
8 songs, 9
Every song is 1 minute except minutes. One. That's 2 minutes.
I like it. Well, 9 minutes and 48 seconds. I'm boosted. But 8 songs, 9 minutes. It is an instrumental album as well.
Mm. Interesting.
I thought like you said Alchemist. I was thinking. I'm
like, yeah. It was very interesting for the instrumentals this week. Let me play a little bit of that one. Because what I will say is that in its 9 minutes, phenomenal.
Yeah.
Phenomenal.
No, Alchemist is definitely one of my favorite producers of all time.
Me too.
Hands down.
Me too. Like it sounds very movie score esque. Like yeah. If you thought Madlib sound. Sorry, go ahead.
Bro, that's crazy that you said that. I always pictured movies whenever I listen to Alchemist beats. Like it's just like it's like some mafia kind of shit. Like you know what I mean? Like some dark, gritty. Like
definitely.
Yo, this guy should fucking either write movies or just like do movie scoring.
Has he done it before?
For all we know, probably.
Yeah. Man, I wouldn't be surprised.
20 plus.
Yeah.
Wouldn't be surprised at all, but the way we were kind of saying with Madlib, it kind of sounds like you're at a live play. No, this one, like I said, I mean, it sounds like a movie score. It sounds like a movie score that would contend for an Academy Award.
Wow. You know what
I'm saying? So definitely worth interesting listen there, I should say. I was
back home smoking legal.
I'll say that. I mean, I don't know what that may or may not mean, but it felt way longer than 9 minutes. It felt like a good 25.
But honestly, that's what instrumentals do. Because I'll be into an instrumental, and I'm like, oh, shit, okay, this instrumental looks like it's done. We're going to be like 1:15 in. And I'm like, oh, shit.
Yeah, like, wait,
but it's because it repeats over and again.
Yeah, and you feel it like it's going. It throws you off rather than you kind of know the timing of bars in your head, right?
Exactly.
I'll play the end of track 4 called Carry the Fire going into track 5. And you'll kind of get an idea as to what I mean with that movie score element to it. Track 4 is about to end now. On track 5. Again, like I said for Madlib, like I said for Mickey Fax, not for everyone.
Yeah.
Might not even be for hip hop heads. I think that's like some weird common theme this week, but it is for lack of better word, maybe hip hop nerds that kind of say, okay, let me catch the intricacies in this. You know mm-hmm. what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And yeah, I mean, I enjoyed it. It's Alchemist. He's one of my favorite. That's gonna be an auto enjoy sort of regardless. I'm gonna have that biased opinion almost every single time. And this continues on that. So Carry the Fire. I listened to it about 4 times. Because 9 minutes, I need like, you know, I need to let it cook a little bit. But I'm definitely, this one's definitely downloaded. This one's definitely going to repeat. I'm looking forward to this one.
Speaking of soundtracks for movies, just a quick look.
A new Beyonce?
He did the original score for GTA 5.
Oh.
Alchemist did it.
Interesting.
With someone named Ono. Yeah, so he did the original score to the highly anticipated game GTA 5 by Rockstar. So
oh, shit.
He has experience doing music for Wow. High with high production and high on budgets. So, wow. But we've all said Alchemist is his grandfather.
He's on my Rushmore.
Like that. He's not on my Rushmore, but I'm not going to disrespect him.
He's definitely up there.
I respect him as a producer. Somewhere. And yeah, it's like he's been around. He's worked with everyone you know, trust me.
Yeah.
Did you listen to Lil Durk?
I did.
Okay, let's quickly end it on that.
It's a deluxe, right?
It's a deluxe, yes.
The deluxe. So what's the record, what's the album called again?
The Voice. He's the voice of the streets.
The Voice deluxe. Before you get to opinion, because it sounds like you don't like it.
No.
I'm joking.
I was just going to say, so I was talking to my brother yesterday, and he was saying that Lil Durk, I'm paraphrasing here, but he said Lil Durk is the hottest / biggest artist or the hardest or in the game right now.
I think he's risen to that tier right now, yes.
Yes.
I still think he's missing something.
Like what?
Missing what?
Like from his music or from his like?
He doesn't have a track. Like what's that record for him right now?
And I know what you're saying. Like he didn't have the track. Like he'd be like, yo, go.
But not every artist is that type of artist.
You know what I mean? So I can't say that.
What's Gucci Mane's track? And don't say it's fucking. Lemonade. She's a very freaky.
Lemonade.
It's not that.
Gucci's got bangers though.
Obviously. Yeah. But I'm saying he does it through abundance.
That's true. That's fair.
Right? Lil Wayne does it through abundance. He just happens to have fucking hit, you know what I'm saying? Behemoths on top of that.
That's what I'm saying. High level tracks. And Durk has high level tracks, but I still don't think he's on that level yet. He's still behind even his contemporaries. If you're going to compare him to the rest of his people, like who is his contemporaries?
I think he's been doing a sound for a long time that is now at the forefront of hip hop. Mm-hmm. And I think he's one of the best at that sound. And I think he's now caught the public heat to go along with his talent.
I think he's going
to
catch one.
So I do think, yeah.
He hasn't had that blow up track, but I think he has good tracks.
But he's had Cry Later.
That's what, yeah.
Like, I mean, his track alone. Like, or not his track alone, but like,
I'm still waiting on him. I can't give him that stamp of approval yet.
The albums.
His last album last
year. You can do it that way.
His last album, I can't remember what it was.
I'm not saying
Ty Dolla Sign.
I'm not saying he's shit by any stretch.
What's Ty Dolla Sign's song?
Spicy. She my spicy little mama.
That came out this year. last year.
That's your one Ty Dolla Sign record. I don't know.
That's the first one that came to my mind.
So Ty Dolla Sign clearly doesn't have a song. But would you say he's at the top of that tier?
Nah, he's not.
Just because y'all
were. Ty Dolla Sign's not on the top tier either.
Okay.
He's on the outside.
I guess.
I don't put Ty Dolla Sign on the top tier.
Better now.
I don't put Ty Dolla Sign on the top tier.
He's not in the top tier.
He's not top tier in his lane?
Well, he's only one in his lane, in my opinion.
Yeah. What lane is he?
In hip hop, as a general, he's not a top tier.
He's not a top tier feature?
He's a top tier. He's Lil Durk. He's a top tier feature.
He's not in my tier one of like when I was supposed to.
Is he a top tier artist? Like standalone artist himself? No. Nah.
He's not top tier artist.
Nah.
He's a top tier feature. He's not top tier artist. He's like on my level two.
He's not there yet. And maybe he never will be. Who knows? But he still has. I'm not saying shit. But like, I'm just saying he's not on that level for
him. Lil Durk's not a top tier level in the artist.
He's definitely a top tier feature.
He hasn't hit it. I get what he's saying. He hasn't hit that top tier artist level, like hip hop artist. He's missing something, and maybe it's that blow up track that's going to be.
He hasn't had a hit in a long time.
3 years from now, you hear that track like, "Oh shit, it's Lil Durk."
So I guess you guys kind of mean like in the court of public opinion in some ways.
I don't know. That's just my opinion.
I mean, that is a factor, of course. That is a factor. I'm not denying that.
I'll speak for me personally. I'm just saying he hasn't had a track that has like an undeniable smash.
I know what you're saying. Yeah.
Undeniable smash.
He doesn't have this on God's plan.
He doesn't need a God's. Not even a God's.
Just an example.
God's plan is like lightning in a bottle.
And that's what I mean. It's just an example of that. Yeah. Like he needs just that breakout track. Just like, yo, that Lil Durk track from 5 years ago, we still bumping.
I can't be mad at that.
But shout out to Lil Durk, though.
I can't refute that. I can't refute that at all. You guys are correct. I can't be mad at that at all. Some statistical features of this album. That's what I was like, before we get into that. either way, don't matter. This one, 12 songs have been added to the beginning
of the album. 12
songs.
12 songs to the beginning.
Fuck. None feature King Von, if you cared.
I'm going for the Brazilian guy still.
I always bet on Brazilians.
Yeah, he looks serious with it. He looks serious with
ooh,
it.
Ooh, gym.
I need a gym too, bro. Low key.
Dude, that's all I want. Yo, just to go to a gym.
My push-up challenge, man, is working.
I need a gym. I just want a gym.
My muscles are bored though. Like I'm just bored of doing the same shit.
I care about fitness, man. I know, but I don't like, want it to be fun.
I don't. But like, that's the thing. I want a gym. It is, it is fun to me. Like doing switching up the exercises. You know,
do yoga.
I tried. Don't get me wrong. I do some stuff at home, try that. But I think yoga would be good for me right now. Just, I just like get, in a gym, like me, gym libraries. Different, when I'm in that zone, I know like for the next hour and a half, I'm in. When I'm at home, trying to switch weights, trying to like load up a video, I'm just like, it's too much work.
The vibe's off.
The vibe's off. There,
yeah. Yeah.
The vibe just throws me. You gotta deal with what you got, man.
You do. You're right.
That's true.
I have been, but it's hard.
The freaking stream just went out. That's crazy.
Oh no, it's still playing.
No, the man said, "Oh, we're sorry.
We're having some technical difficulties here."
Sorry, man.
How did you guys hear that?
We didn't.
I'm like, what?
Oh, that knee to the stomach is crazy. Anyways, quick question about Lil Durk.
Yes.
Did you see the video for Kanye Crazy, which is one of the records on the deluxe
version? I heard the song, but I haven't heard the video.
Video is pretty fire.
Is it? Is Kanye
Lil
in it?
Lil Durk is reenacting every prominent Kanye scene.
Oh, shit.
Oh, I've seen a little snippets of like moment, pictures and shit.
The Sway moment.
You ain't got the answer, Sway. You ain't got the answer. Moments,
even when he's playing the pianos with the thing.
Was it like
the
runaway
thing? I think it was the church. Ding. I think it was the Sunday ding. Service.
Oh, okay.
When he was playing it recently.
You had the one with the bulletproof vest on.
I didn't watch the full video. Oh, okay. I just watched the one minute highlight on Instagram. But yeah, that looks like it would be a really fire video. I want to see how the whole thing turned out for that. But yeah, I mean, Lil Durk, what's it called again?
The Voice Deluxe.
I didn't write it down. The Voice Deluxe, 12 songs added to the beginning.
I listened to it.
We didn't give any opinion.
It's okay. Like, if you listen to the first part of The Voice, there's like more songs added.
Yeah.
And I'm probably going to listen to it eventually, but I've just been jerked out. He released like a lot last year, and I think King Von's
and I like
King Von's album a lot more, so I've been bumming a lot more King Von.
Yeah, and I think to Dill's point, like, and this is in the most respectful way possible, because they are good records, but they don't stand out. Right? Nope. It kind of feels like homogenous in some ways. It's just one sound, like a playlist.
Yeah.
Yep. And I was bumping it like that. I was just kind of walking in and out. I wasn't necessarily paying attention.
That's how I listen to Lil Durk.
And it's not necessarily bad. It's just like,
you know,
and I like the fact that he's trying to do some different stuff, like with like the videos and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. So I feel like he's gonna catch something soon.
Yeah,
like if he just keeps consistent,
like he's already caught the collective, but
he has
the one.
That takes him to the next level.
I'm not mad at
it's
that.
It's coming. I feel like it's coming this
the
year.
The one that
for
hits
sure.
every playlist just naturally because it's getting played. Like,
he's
in the box
type
of song. Just that one song naturally just everyone catches on to.
Yeah, no, I'm not and mad I get at that it. At all. I'm not mad at that at all.
I think that's all.
I think that's it too.
Because I didn't listen to any other albums.
I didn't listen to anything else either.
I listened to that single by A.R. Priestley called Streets. He's from Toronto. I don't know where in Toronto.
A.R. Priestley?
Yeah. Fire song.
A.R. Paisley?
Oh, is it Paisley?
Yeah.
It's probably Paisley.
It's from Saga.
Saga? Yeah. So he's been around a while. I've seen his name. You want to play that quickly? It's called Streets by
A.R. Paisley. Yeah, he's nice though. He can rap.
Man, you spelled it wrong. So how do I spell it? P-A-I?
Just put A-R. Paisley. P. A-R space P and it'll come up. Because that's what I did on Instagram or on. And it's called Street. Will be his latest release. It's a bump.
This is A.R. Paisley.
Oh, Paisley.
Paisley Worldwide, 100,000 monthly. That's crazy. And this one's called Streets.
Yes.
Okay, let's bump that. Oh, I gotta press play. Not the record.
Yeah, drop that. Make it pop to the beat. Watch what you saying when you talking to me. Got me going through a like spree and all of her tweets. But I can't wife that cause she belongs to the streets. Twerk that, make it bop to the beat.
Okay, okay.
That's the chorus, by the way. He actually does some little bit better rapping
throughout. I just want to see who produced that. That's produced by JP Sounds.
The beat is fire.
It's a groovy beat.
Watch what you sent. Meta at the club. I was driving past the 5-0. I don't drink and drive though. Chilling while I ride slow. Meta at the club. That's a dub. I don't trust her though. On top of that, I think she knows it isn't one of those. Drop that.
I like his vibe. He's funny. Like, I was on his Instagram.
Nah,
he's
cool.
He's actually like a cool guy. Like, I'll be friends with this guy in real life. Like, he sounds like his music is fun. So
yeah, he's been putting out shit for a while still, to be honest. Like, and he can actually rap. Like, he does, like, rapper shit, too. Like, he's not, like, tracks like this, which is cool. Mm-hmm. But he can actually rap
if
as well.
If you read his bio, it says he's a lyricist.
To make a song, though, right?
Yeah, and I like it.
I like when artists that, when we know they can rap, great.
Make a song.
When they can try to make a song and it has a sound to it that you actually enjoy, it's like, okay.
Yeah.
I see what you did there. Shout out to you.
His bio says he's a lyricist, too. So when I heard this, I'm like, this is a lyricist? But I'm like, you know what? You're just making a song. You got to get your name out there somehow.
Facts.
Exactly.
Now people start listening to you.
Like, that's what that's music, bro. You gotta make some songs sometimes.
Yeah, J. Cole's on. What's that song that J. Cole didn't want to put out that he on his first album? Remember that one song he didn't want?
Dream Ranger.
Not Wet Dreams.
Was it Wet Dreams?
No, on his first album that he said he didn't want to put out. Oh, but he had to because of the
Mr. Nice Watch.
No,
I don't remember.
That's how every song sounds. The way he's in a basketball court in the video. It's if I remember, I'll find it.
I don't know what you're talking about.
When I say the song, you'll know it.
Anyways, man, shout out to AR Paisley again. That one is called Streets.
Saga City, the sweeter side.
That out. I think it's, what do you call that segment again? What's in your wallet? What's in your rotation?
What's in your wallet?
let's go through our rotation, man. Let's go through our rotation. All what right, have we been listening let's take to? A
look. I don't think I listened to that much music.
I'm still looking for this J. Cole song. Yo, so
up until like Friday, I had like one album on my list. I'm like, oh shit, I haven't bumped shit this week. So I started bumping everything Friday afternoon, pretty much.
And the song I'm talking about is Workout.
Oh, yeah.
Remember he said like another song and he didn't really want to come out with it, but the label said he needed a hot song.
Would you go?
No, man. I remember like, I'm literally saying like 1 second in my head. That's why, like, you know, it's, trust me, 1 second out of a four minute song.
Yo, PND released Colors on streaming.
Yes, I saw that.
I don't know. I didn't hear about that.
I was not going to talk about that.
Good thing we're in music potpourri, though.
Yeah.
Can I start this week? Or
yeah,
you want
to
start?
Go ahead. I don't matter to me.
I listened to Present, 3-pack. Shout out to Present.
Okay.
If more to come soon on that.
You know the vibes.
Rap Caviar. I listened to, maybe that's where I got that. No, that's not where I got in the streets. King Von playlist. Went on King Von and just, you know, like I said, King Von's one of my favorite artists.
Like an artist shuffle?
Like an artist shuffle.
Okay.
Honestly, I didn't listen to anything King Von other than his last album. Went to his artist shuffle, just said, I'm like, you know what? He would have been my favorite artist, man. Shout out to Chicago. Life of a Dark Rose by Lil Skies. I listened to that. That's his first album. The Goat by Polo G. One of my favorite albums ever. Poetic Pain by 2C. And then this is when I go into my weird bag. I listened to this place called Acoustic Rap.
Yeah.
And it has songs like Ty Dolla $ign, Horse in the Stable, Liquor Locker by Vic Mensa, Yosemite. It's more of acoustic songs that were rap by rappers.
That's pretty cool, though.
A few plays of that. I listened to this Drake piano covers, which is just someone playing piano covers of Drake songs, which I don't know. I like instruments. That's why these instrumentals, I was like, yo, I might have to bump some of these. Guitar type beats.
That's on Spotify? You searched Drake piano and you found it?
I searched acoustic rap and it just came out as one of
them.
This one's a good called Guitar Type Beats, which type beats with heavy guitar influence. I'll just play one quickly. Actually, no, I like this one better. It's like this. A little lo-fi
this
beat.
Guy was
just
on
to,
the instrumentals this week.
I was spitting verses in my head.
Jeez. Shola got bars.
My name is Shola.
Yeah, it was not bars. And then just my regular old Toronto players with some Pressa, some Killy on it, some Tory Lanez, some Smoke Dog. Well, Pressa featuring Tory Lanez, Lil Barrette. And then, yeah, that's about it. My Hall of Fame players is just a bunch of songs I've liked over the last 20 something odd years of my life. That's it.
Oh,
like
okay.
Over time, any song that I've always come
I
back
thought you
to.
Meant press like on Spotify for the last 20 years. I'm like, this app has been out for like. Five years. That made no sense. Dill, you want to go or you want me to go?
I'll go. So I think it was like the anniversary for Starboy. Starboy turned 5 years old.
So yeah. I saw that. Yeah.
Yeah. So I was bumping that, and then it led me into listening to Kiss Land, which I think is The Weeknd's best album that he's ever released. The Carter Five. Then that led me to listening to Party Next Door. So I listened to Party Next Door 2, or is that 3? I can't tell. No, that's 2. And then Party Mobile. And then Amusing Her Feelings, not Amusing Her Feelings. And then Colors. And then after that, I was listening to Beast Mode, Future, Shake the Snow Globe by Russ, Vori by Vori, Wavy Baby Bees, Trap Bees. That shit is fire. St. Clair West by Eric Andretti. And then No Love Lost by Blast.
I thought you said you barely listened to music.
I just realized I did. I listened to a lot of music then.
You got it. Yeah, in terms of my rotation... A few records for sure. I listened to Chain Gang by Present. You know the vibes.
Shout out to Present.
Cowboy Trappin' by Present as well.
Jeez. Cowboy Trappin'.
I bumped Redemption by J-Rock.
Okay, that's a fire album.
That was one of my favorite albums.
Fire album.
Yeah. 2019. I had to relive that one. I was like, yo, still
was it 2018 fire. Or 2019?
2018. 18, yeah. I remember that year in music. That was a great year.
That was a good year.
Crazy year, actually, yeah.
That was a great year of music.
That's probably the last time our top 10s will ever line up that way.
I listened to Reroute, that Rowdy Rebel record. Oh, yeah. With Funk Flex. I like that one. Speaking of artist shuffle play, I did one for Lupe Fiasco. Mm-hmm. Because I am too biased in that I always go to...
the albums you like.
I always go to Food and Liquor or The Cool. So I'm like, let me add some Tetsuo. Let me add some other Lupe records in there as well. I bumped A Written Testimony by J Electronica.
Electronica. I'm like, yo, who that? Cool. Like, that's his brother?
I bumped a Spilligion.
Spilligion.
Bears Like This Too Much. Bears Like This Too. Oh,
my bad.
It's okay. It happens. And yeah, just those three projects by, of course, Spillage Village. I bumped. What else did I bump? Like his mollies. And I guess I'll include Carry the Fire by Alchemist in there because I bumped that several times. So that kind of closes out my rotation. I guess that closes out the music potpourri.
Music potpourri.
So I guess the only thing that's left.
Oh, what that?
Is the post potpourri.
Boom.
Post potpourri.
Right. I didn't see this. So, are you getting one? DJ Baskin Robbins.
If you would like to press the Twitter link now. Yes. If you'd like to press the Twitter link that has been provided. And I want to know, first of all, let me tell you what happened. And let me ask if you would get one as you think about your answer. In the Bay Area, you can now get a verified badge crest on your home. If you are an influencer, a public figure, or represent a brand.
Okay.
So... I want to ask you, because we are influencers and public figures, and we represent a brand. Are you getting...
I have a question, though. What's the usefulness of this? Like,
what's the usefulness of a verified badge on Twitter?
But that's different on Twitter. When you tweet something...
Is it?
No. When you tweet something, then I can be like, okay, you're verified. I can... know okay. There's a level
and
to
I
this.
And I walk by the houses and say, okay, you're verified.
But what does that do if your house is verified?
What does it do on Twitter?
It gives you credibility.
I'll tell you what it does in real life. Especially in the Bay Area.
In the Bay Area, I get it, though. Like,
I don't get it. Because it's Tech City. Like, it's like putting a sign on your house saying, rob me, please.
Oh, you're awesome. And that was my next question.
You know how many BNEs are on the West Coast, bro? Like, what's happening over there?
Why would you want that,
though? Let me put my verified badge on here. Let them know that I have some shit over here.
I get free shit from a company.
Let me imagine just rubbing their hands, like doing a Birdman hand rub.
But you would imagine, like, it's no different than living in a rich area, though, right? Like, every area.
But that just lets me know, okay, that's the house we go to.
You want to go to that house? You don't want to go to the oil tycoon?
Well, maybe we could go there, too. Shit.
You don't want to go to the tech guru?
Let me just stop here on my way to their house.
You don't want to go to the tech guru in Silicon Valley?
Tech guru gave the influencer all this shit to promote.
That's true, but he's probably got security.
That's what I'm saying.
He probably got security. See, the billionaire's not putting a check mark because he's smart enough to be like, yo, I don't need to tell you what I do. Nigga, my money talks for itself. Mm-hmm. And that's my thing about, like, putting a check. I don't need to tell you what I do. Like, you from the outside of
get
my house,
in the chopper,
walking by my house, I don't give a fuck. If you're not in my house, why do you care about what I do? Mind your business. Mind your business.
Mind your business.
Just, that's all. Mind your business.
Mind your business.
What's the saying? Mind the business that minds you or something like that?
Yeah, I don't know.
I don't know.
Mind your business. That's all. Mind your business. You got to get that one eye too or with a tweak. I fucking love that show, man.
Oh, man. But shout out to the influencers.
Anything else random, man? Like, anything going on in the world?
I don't know. January's kind of quiet.
It's just...
GameStop.
You want to get into it?
Y'all got your GameStop shares?
I don't stocks. I don't do stocks.
I don't do stocks.
I don't have time to do it. I'm not in stocks market. I'm not in business.
You don't need to.
I don't do stocks. My money's coming from somewhere else. Don't worry. It's just not stocks.
That's fair.
It's just what it is.
That's fair.
That's not fair.
That is fair. Not everyone could be in stocks.
Everyone should be in stocks.
I'm not in business. I've never once looked into stocks.
Every single person should be in stocks. At least
you do and what benefits you. It's like saying you should be in tech. Person. Tech is the future.
No, that's what I'm saying.
Stocks
is
work.
I'm talking about owning stock.
That's
you
work.
Want to own part of the companies that are ruling today and tomorrow.
That's
until I own my own company. Like, don't worry. That's what I'm saying. Like, I'm not doing stocks. Like, I'm not sheep, bro. I work what works best for me. Doing stocks is a full-time job to me. I got to follow stocks. Because you work in that industry. You can do it anytime. When I'm at work for those 8 hours, I can't be looking at stocks. I work in something totally different. From 8 to 5.
The perspective is just so...
I'm not doing stocks.
But that's...
That's a personal thing. Stocks for you is a personal thing. Because I can say invest your money in something else, and you'd be like, no, I wouldn't do that. But to me,
the way
that's
you're describing it is not accurate, though.
Yeah, it's not accurate.
Hey, but that's what I'm saying. To me,
that's okay. Yeah, but like, I would just say, do some research on it.
Everyone should.
And that's I don't have the time to do that research, so I'm not going to start doing this just because I go on Twitter and see, oh shit, GameStop's rising.
I'm not talking about GameStop at this point. Forget GameStop.
But even in general,
there's a very important PSA for the audience here.
Yeah, man.
I think everyone to truly, because we've never been afforded generational wealth. Mm-hmm. I think the way that we try to build generational wealth.
The way you try to build it. No. Say you, because I'm not building my generational wealth through stocks. So don't make it everyone.
I think it's a PSA to everyone. This is my PSA. There we go.
Harris is talking, not Shola. This is the words of Shola, and do not speak the words.
I've never been negated in a stock conversation before.
And that's my thing, is that everyone believes that. Everyone believes. Let me finish. Everyone believes that stocks are this thing. That you need to invest it. And I get it. There is a lot of money in stocks, but not everyone is going to benefit from stocks. And I'm one of those people. I have my money. And before stocks, I have my money going somewhere else. And in a few years from now, that money going to work. That's just it. I just don't believe in, I don't believe in stocks. I just don't do stocks because I've never been a business person. I've never been into business. I've never cared about it.
I would just say check it out.
That's it. But again, look into it yourself. That's the thing. Myself, I know what works for me, and that doesn't work for me. For Harris, it works.
I would like to give a PSA to the audience.
I understand it. Don't work Harris's for you. Words, not mine. Right. It's Harris talking right now.
Harris, drop
Harris's
the PSA.
Harris's words are not
PSA
mine.
Fantastic.
Let's put it that way.
The PSA for us.
The thing with stocks, the reason why I think everyone should be in stocks is because we haven't been afforded the ability to build generational wealth, and the way that generational wealth comes is by the exponential growth that the companies that rule the world participate in. Right now, what stock allows you to do is stock allows you to own a part of those companies that grow in exponential value over the years. So for example, a company like Apple, as they get into healthcare, as they get into self-driving cars, we think about Apple in 2030 and we're like, oh my God, it's going to be 1,000 times more valuable than it is today.
Right.
Just a random number, right? So what am I going to do? I put a dollar in there and it's worth $1,000 in 2030, mm-hmm. right? So you build that generational wealth through companies that you sort of ask yourself, hey, which ones are going to be on top of the world? Which ones are this? Which ones are that? Misconception about stock is that you have to be in business. You really don't. You just have to think about the brands and the companies that you use.
Yeah, I was just gonna say,
like Jordans, Nike.
I'm spending money on these guys anyways. Why not own a piece of it?
Exactly, right? So that's a good usually place to start. The second place to start with people is you want to think about industries in general. So you want to think, okay, the healthcare industry is prominent right now.
Right.
How do I get into that industry? The technology industry is booming. We're going through another tech boom the way we did in 2000. Okay, how do I get myself attached to technology?
Right.
Biotech, renewable energy, whatever it may be. You kind of say, okay, I want to see these industries and sectors, and I want to latch onto a part ownership because when they skyrocket in value, so do I.
Right.
So I think to Shola's point, because you bring up a great point, a lot of people are in it, follow Bati, don't know what they're
doing. And that's one thing I know. Yep. I agree with you on that. Some people are just like, oh.
And that's why I'm saying I wanted to get this PSA out. Because a lot of, and obviously I'm reacting the way I'm reacting, but a lot of people think like that because they haven't been in the conversations. And that's fair. That's absolutely fair. Mm-hmm. But
some people like me just have no interest. Like, I have no interest in stocks. I've thought about stocks and I've thought about ways to make money, and stocks was not my way because I have no interest in it. I thought of different ways. I'm like, you know what? I'll work into these ways. That's just what I'm saying. Like, it's not like I'm like, oh, fuck stocks. It's just like, I just don't care about it. It's not interested. It doesn't interest me. I have no, it's more gambling to me. And honestly, every business is gambling because your business could fail. You can invest $10,000 into something and it fails. But that's just me. Again, that's just me personally.
I just wanted to.
That's all I'm saying.
There's a million ways to make money.
There's a million, exactly. There's a million ways to make money.
Infinite ways to make money.
But I do have a question. I have a question, though.
Go ahead.
Now, my final message is do your research.
I was watching the Joe Budden, the JBP the other day. Okay. And they had that guy Pump on it.
Who?
Did you see that episode? I think it was last week.
With the,
they're talking about Bitcoin. Yeah, yeah. Crypto, yeah. So he's saying, like, if you have 100% of your money in the bank, you're doing it wrong. But I want to ask, though, like, for banks, like, when you have your money in the bank,
correct,
do they then take that money and then invest it? Yeah. And then...
No, what they do is they...
Because they say, like, well, yeah, your money builds interest, but where does that interest come from?
They do something.
So what happens is, yeah, I mean, with your you put money into a bank and they say, hey, we're going to give you 1% for a savings account.
Right.
That you have that... there, right? You can't just walk in and say, give me all my money. They're gonna say, hey man, yo, you got to give us a little bit of a warning.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
unless you want like a draft or a check or something like that, right? Or unless you write a check. But essentially, if the bank knows they have $100 in the bank, they're gonna lend $100,
right?
Of course.
Hey, take this $100 and pay 5% interest on it as an example. Or let's say it's a loan, pay 15% interest on it as an example.
Yeah.
But they don't have that $100, but they gave you it because they know they have your savings here.
Right.
So as a result, they say, hey man, if you leave it in here, we're going to give you a shiny 1%, man. And they're going to make that 4% spread.
Right.
Right. So ultimately, the name of the game is that savings accounts shouldn't even be real. They shouldn't exist. Your money should never be in a savings
account. Yeah.
Your money should always be in some kind of investment.
So that's where I made the switch. I use my TFSA for pay
the bank anyway.
My investments. Like I'll use it for use
the
whatever.
Bank, if you're going to pay the bank anyway.
Yeah, fuck it.
They might as well pay you. you know what I'm saying? So, yeah, I mean, again, PSA is that research is very important. There are legitimate ways to build generational wealth. It doesn't require... you know, a large amount of capital. You want to just sort of treat it in the way that you would treat savings, which is a blessing in its own right, because I know that that's not something that everyone has. But again, if it's sitting there doing nothing, it's devaluing on a yearly basis.
Yeah.
And you should be doing something with it rather than letting the bank kind of hold on to it for free. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, I mean, that's the only PSA I have. Otherwise... I think that's it.
Yeah, I got nothing else.
I think that's it.
I'm good.
Any more questions, comments, concerns, inquiries?
Questions, comments,
I'm just
concerns.
Really asking for the people out there in the universe.
We're doing our duty. We're doing our duty.
It's my duty.
Please.
To please the booty.
Please. In that case, cue that music. Split decision, baby. That was the final fight of the parlay. You know the vibes. How much did I fucking get there? Hold on.
Pretty boy, about to get a braid up like that.
He's gonna come out here looking different. Like, is that Dylan or Dill Dot?
It's Caramel Poppy.
Caramel Poppy.
Holy. One more two. Oh, the guy just won. You just saw him split decision. Holy. 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 Let's go.
Return is mod still.
Let's go. And then this mod return. Pereira just won. Holy.
Wow.
It's caking.
Yo, split decision. Holy, bro.
That's how you're living?
Bro. That wow. Shit. Yo. Shit. I might make that ASOS order still.
Jeez, I said
anyways, ASOS man. Cue it again, please, if you don't mind. Because that being said, that will take us to the end.
Huh?
The unfortunate end of another episode of the True North Views podcast. So please continue that conversation.
Please.
By telling a friend.
Tell 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 a friend.
To tell a friend. Please. I was following the script rather than what we're supposed to say, which is comment,
rate, subscribe.
Like. That little button down there. Hit it. You know what I'm saying?
It helps the algos.
Hit the bell. That one up there, hit the bell. It's I think that's like notifications.
It's down there. It's up there?
It's,
No, it's beside the subscribe button.
Subscribe.
Hit the bell.
Hit the bell. Hit the likes.
You know hit saying? The likes. Make a comment. What don't you like? Let us know what you don't like.
And
pause it and go back.
For those that want slightly shorter episodes, just listen to us on 1.25 speed. Pro
tip. That's actually a thing. Like some podcasts, I listen to at 1.25. I listen to them at 1.5.
Mm-hmm. Like, interesting.
Like I don't need to hear you every single. I just need to get the concept of what you're saying.
And... Like I can hear you. Know, I can hear a fast version of the conversation.
Exactly.
Like,
okay, just talk fast. Like along, that. You know it's not that hard.
It's actually not.
It's actually pretty nice. Yo, actually.
Tariq versus Rico.
Yo.
Yo, bro.
Do you have money on this one?
I'm good. I won, bro.
I feel bad for Tariq.
I won, bro.
Bad for Tariq.
Oh, Rico was the first guy we watched.
No, yeah.
Rico's gonna
cook it.
Rico was cooking.
Mm. Anyways, man. Anyways, as usual, I go by the name of Harris.
It's Dill Dot. It's the podcast K Dot, aka Caramel Poppy, aka the Caramel God, pulling up from the logo. Three pointers only. Bang, 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 bang.
I pressed that by accident, but that works.
that was song.
Rewind.
Skirt Master here, Mr. Triple Double himself, zero assists. And Jesus. Giving 70 mil from the TTC. NBA Championship. You can call me Just Show.
That was accident too, see? Like,
hey, man, it just be sliding sometimes.
Anyways, man, please, 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 before I do any more accidents, just tell them that number one rule.
Watch out for the Wastemans.
Watch out for the motherfucking Wastemans. You know the vibes. You know what it is. True North Views podcast. True North Views. Feeling good, feeling great. How about you? Episode 140.
How about you?
Peace. We out.